On a guess, lend me your ears. Long as our Fevremonde suffered, without a true monarch to guide her and her people. Decades have passed since last His Majesty Erland sat atop the Draken throne. Long have we endured, yet it has not been for naught. At last, the bell has tolled on the age of the Consul. At last, we may celebrate the coming of our rightful ruler. The return of the Sovereign.
My word, such an inspiring visage.
Your Majesty shall have my eternal fealty.
Your Majesty, oh, how long I have waited this moment.
Behold, before you sits the rightful inheritor of the Draken throne, chosen by the dragon as its enemy. Behold and rejoice! Fortune has delivered us our savior at last!
At last!
Praise be, for only the Sovereign's guidance can lead us true. All hail the Sovereign!
All hail!
Let all present pledge your allegiance to the Sovereign. Let us be united in the hope that our liege's reign will ne'er end. Long live the Sovereign of Vermont!
Long live the Sovereign!
Arisen, thou who wouldst slay the dragon, if thou seekest to behold this world in its true aspect, abandon thy reason. Cast aside thine heart and thy life both. I ask thee to demonstrate thy will, for naught but thine ambition can alter the course of the rivers of fate.
Now, which one of you was it? No need to be shy. I've just got to take down a record of your name and face. Come on, step forward. Are you the one then? Aha, I thought I recognized you. Thank you. I ill like that look in your eyes. 'Tis queerly brazen for a pawn. Most of your kind have eyes blank as a cadaver's. Mayhap 'tis only natural, seeing as how you rise from the dead. There's aught different about you, though. Could it be that you fear death just as we mortals do? Worry not, vessel. 3 days here, and you'll be longing for death's sweet embrace. Come along, you feckless dullards. Get a move on!
Do your injuries pain you? Pray, do not overexert yourself. This is no place for one of your ilk. 'Tis harsh beyond measure. Even we pawns are pushed to the brink. You ought not anger the overseer. Let us proceed to the site. I do not understand how 'tis they compel us. There is no arisen among the overseers.
Time for you to get to work.
You are prepared to work. Then you all begin by carrying stones out from the station in the back and bringing them here.
Is quite cluttered. Pray leap over aught that poses a hindrance to you.
I suppose these are my just desserts.
A job well done. Now the next step is to... What is this commotion? Perhaps we ought to investigate. An opening, then press your boat till they are overwhelmed. These may not carry shields, but their nimbleness allows them to dodge incoming attacks. Boulders, barrels, and the like can make effective weapons of clever combatants. When delivering targeted strikes, I would recommend clinging to your boat.
No one could survive a fall from this height. Not even a pawn. Don't just stand there! Shoot it down!
Ah! learn all you can of this world, you must protect.
Pray, keep your distance, Arisen. Worry not for me. The brine may swallow me whole, but I will not perish. There is a stone not far from here, known as a rift stone. Pray, seek it out. If you are truly the Arisen, then our paths will surely cross again.
What happened here? A griffin appears one moment and falls the next. And now you stand before me. Was it you then? The one who was riding on its back? It is a wonder you survived. Accompany me to the stronghold. We'll treat your wounds and hear your story.
A single bolt from a ballista. And well aimed at that. Must be one of Ser Linnet's from out of Melv.
Where exactly is this jail you say you escaped from, anyway? I've never heard of such a place. There's certainly naught like that here in Vermont. Could it be you were held in the neighboring country of Batal? Nay, I suppose that's unlikely. We've been estranged from Batal ever since the war. It is difficult to imagine any citizen of Vermont being sent there.
Fie! Goblins! Let's take up your weapon, sir. You'll be needing it.
You can find your strength flight, buy the curative or have a bit of green wash. When one of the fiends comes to you, best guard or dodge, else you'll be sore on the morrow. Make use of the slope. It will give you an advantage against their ranks. Employ guarded attacks to get the enemy to flinch. Brander attacks are... There are oft items to be scavenged from the bodies of monsters and their ilk. If you're not squeamish about picking at their bones, that is. Where are you going? I'll not fall... Where do you think you're going? You can't just run off now.
Welcome, Arisen. We pawns have long awaited your arrival.
What is this? The pawns? They bend the knee to you so readily, but then... No. Surely you cannot be the Arisen.
You seek the Rift Stone, do you not? We can take you to it. Pray. Come this way. Before you stands a Rift Stone. Tis a gate by which we of the Pawn Legion may cross o'er into this world. Pray, summon your pawn. Simply paint with your mind's eye the loyal attendant whom you would have serve you. The people here are evacuated, and safe for the moment. There are more who can yet be saved. It seems the rain has abated. Former Arisen appear to be plentiful in this world. Danger might lurk anywhere. Wear every shadow, and mind the ceiling. 'Tis a weight off our minds to have it done. Very well. I shall await further orders. Pawns are oft called nomads, for we wander between this world and the many other realms with which we are connected. I am no exception, and my experiences in these other worlds will doubtless be of aid to you on your adventure. 'Tis my privilege to accompany you as your loyal pawn, and I will gladly use the knowledge I gain to guide you.
Well, I'll be. A pawn summoning before my very eyes. You truly are the Arisen, then. Strange. I thought the Arisen was in the capital. Surely there's only meant to be one Arisen. Fie, this is all beyond my ken. The Watchhead would know what to do, I'm sure. Though, as luck would have it, he's away. I suppose we'll save any further questions till the Watchhead returns. You're free to do as you like afore then. What? You've no memories, you say? Mayhap you could make for Melv, then. 'Twas set upon by the dragon not long ago. The Arisen is said to bear some deep connection to the dragon. Should you be Arisen, mayhap you'll recall aught of import there.
Hail, Arisen. Pray, ask aught you wish to know. I shall answer, if 'tis within my power to do so. Nomads, we are oft called. Born in other worlds, we travel here by means of the Rift Stones that we might aid you, Arisen. However, I cannot speak as to our true nature, for I know of it not. None of us do. We do not need to. We merely do as we are commanded. Rift Stones are gates that connect this world to a multitude of others. By their power have we crossed into this world, and when our mission is done, by their power shall we return to our own. 'Tis the name given to fate's chosen, those destined to command the Pawn Legion and safeguard the world from the threat of the dragon. Even with your memories lost to you, I am afraid you cannot escape your fate. Very well. May fortune speed you on your way, Arisen.
I've a knack for gathering items and am ever on the hunt for new finds. I'll gladly try out any useful mechanisms I espy.
You can count on me to fly to your aid in your hour of need, Master. Knowing when to use curatives is my specialty.
Thank you.
Restoration and reinforcement are the purview of a mage. You'll be safe in my care, Arisen. Are you fit to travel? Then let's not dawdle. I enjoy tackling fierce foes and prefer combat's thrills to gathering items. I am confident and may act independently.
Should you need to communicate in Elvish, pray call upon me. I would be only too glad to assist. Delighted to meet you, especially if we share a sweet tooth.
It's as stiff as boards after training.
Everyone's as tired as I am.
Fancy a gander? I find goods for sale. Fancy a gander? I find goods for sale. always have a warm welcome for a customer. Always a pleasure.
Not buying? That's just as well. Better to be selective than wasteful.
Gold is a resource best spent judiciously. A treasure chest. Shall we see if we can't make our way over to it?
Going out, are you? You sure that's a good idea? You seem rather unwell.
You ought at least rest for the evening. There should be a spare bed in the lodgings yonder. Only don't go rushing off before you're ready. Take it from me. You're better off resting while you have the chance.
Fancy a gander? I'd find goods for sale.
You need me at the Vanguard? Say no more. Tis a ladder. Shall we see where it leads?
Ah, excellent find.
I'm dead on my feet.
Training. Time to be heading home.
Hoi there. You seem well tired. Tell you what, you can stay here tonight free of charge. I'll expect coin from tomorrow, mind. My pa always used to say, there's naught a good night's sleep can't fix. Not much else I can offer, I'm afraid, but you'll find all sorts at a finer inn. Aye, being armed is better than being defenseless, even if you're untrained. Still, 'tis worth devoting yourself to a vocation if you can. Opens up new doors, it does. You should stop by the inn in Melv if you get the chance. No hard feelings if you prefer it. They've much more to offer.
We must rest, though the sun is still up.
Never for a moment did I doubt you'd go stronger someday. Having said that, 'tis quite a relief.
There's no discipline that steadfast devotion cannot teach.
If you seek to restore your memories, Master, methinks a trip to Melv might be just the thing. I know the way. Follow me.
I've beds to spare if you're looking for lodgings. And if you'd like to change your vocation, come see me anytime. Do come again.
Could you come over here?
I'll carefully conserve my strength and endeavor to survive every battle by way of sound strategy and defensive tactics.
Hoi! Arisen! Over here! Surely you didn't think I'd abandon you.
Heyo. You a soldier? Twould be a surprise to see you arrive in one piece, if not. Hordes of monsters have been plaguing this area of late, you see. We've had to start sending out new recruits to cull them.
Is that so? Who went yonder?
Lachlan. But I dare say he'll fare all right.
Aye, I expect he will. Who was sent out that way, then?
Accardo. To be honest, sir, I'm a little worried for him.
What? Weren't harpies reported in that area? The lad can't handle those beasts on his own.
This is the first I'm hearing of it. Fie! I want to go to his aid, but we can't just abandon our posts. Say, you seem stout of heart. Would you be willing to go in our stead? 'Tisn't far, only a short ways out from the main gate. You've my thanks. And Accardo's as well, I'm sure.
Perhaps we ought to hurry, lest we arrive too late to be of aid. Sir Ricardo is in need of our aid. Methinks I know where to find the person you're looking for.
A guide is most welcome. Now we shan't lose our way.
Freshly rested as we are, this battle ought to be in our favor. You truly are formidable, Arisen.
Is that all of them?
You have my thanks. I do not believe for a moment I could have slain those creatures without your help. I've only just enlisted, and when I thought this could be the end of me, I was paralyzed. You saved me this time, but I won't always be so fortunate. I'll have to train harder, till I've the confidence to face such beasts on my own. Well, I'd best be heading back, but I'll be sure to let my superiors know of your good deed. I hope we meet again someday.
Shall we report our results? In traversing other worlds, I came to know of a treasure chest in this area. Perchance you'd like to see it. Pray, follow me. I know the way, so there's no chance of our getting lost.
There are useful ingredients to be gathered here, I'll wager.
No harm in picking a few.
Looks promising. Any ideas as to how we might reach it? We have reached our destination.
A fantastic find. I wonder whether my master from beyond the rift managed to find that. Somehow, I doubt it.
I fear I shall lose sight of you if you go much further.
A passage? Here? Truly. There are secrets around every corner.
Pray, keep your wits about you. We needn't go barging in.
You're welcome to take whatever you like from my pack, Master. I'd gladly see you put what I find to good use.
Hail, friend! Many thanks for aiding Accardo. 'Twas a relief to see him return, and none the worse for wear.
Aye, that it was. The poor sod might not have made it back alive had you not intervened.
'Twas a bit too early for him to be seeing actual combat. That much was made well clear. We'll be extending his training period. The instructors here are well known for whipping recruits into shape with their grueling regimes.
Speaking of training regimes, I must admit I've half a mind to ask you to join us. We could use someone with your experience.
I would have preferred not to have to fight so soon, but at least I know I am up to the challenge.
We must not let down our guard.
We are none of us alike in vocation.
Our respective abilities are unique as well.
Let us utilize our individual strengths wherever possible.
Excellent. I could have done no better. Glad to be of service.
I concur.
The enemy has called reinforcements. It seems they mean to match our might through strength of numbers.
Come on.
Look, Master. A chest. We must find a way to open it.
How might we approach it? I only hope I did not disappoint.
Come to think of it, the private quarters of one Arisen I served had many a visitor, and rarely the same one.
Each to their own.
If you seek to restore your memories, Master, methinks a trip to Melv might be just the thing. I can guide you there if you wish.
The guide is most welcome. Now we shan't lose our way.
This way, if you please. Behold the state of the village. 'Tis a sorry sight indeed. The dragon truly is calamity incarnate.
Pitiable arisen.
We're going this way now, I suppose. By your will.
The Arisen decides our path. We have but to follow.
That is most unfortunate, but it doth not release thee from thy fate.
Can you hear me, sir? Sir, stay with me.
Thank you.
thank goodness. How are you feeling? This is the second time I've watched over you like this, isn't it? You do not remember? Then have you forgotten that you protected me from the dragon's flames? You withstood the fire in my stead and were well and truly charred. It was terrible. I had thought your life forfeit. I could not hear the beating of your heart. But you hung on and by some miracle survived. Arisen? I'm afraid I don't understand your meaning. Does it have aught to do with why you were taken to the castle? They said 'twas so that your wounds could be treated, though I fear you have no memory of this either.
I am of the Border Watch. Someone with Arisen-like abilities came to this village, horn in tow. Know you aught of this?
Has he come for you? We are to part so soon, then. Mayhap you will visit me again someday. Till then, take care. Arisen.
Ah, excellent. You must be the one. You match my soldier's description. I'm glad I found you. The ruler of Vermund, currently convalescing in the capital, became arisen here in this very village. If you claim the same, then word must be borne to the capital. I dispatched a missive before coming here, though I doubt the matter can be settled without your presence. Would you be willing to accompany me to the capital? If you truly are arisen, you will be received with open arms. Oh, but forgive me. I scattered my soldiers in a bid to find you. I would not depart without them. We shall have to wait till they are reassembled. Come to think of it, Sir Lennet was asking after you as well. Mayhap now would be a good time to speak with him. Last I saw, he was having a drink at the inn.
Shall we seek some answers?
Have you some business with the apothecary, sir? Dreadful sorry if I was in your way.
Oh, no. I'm not lost or naught, sir. You needn't worry yourself on my account. I'm an apothecary in training, you see. My family runs a little shop in Vernworth.
So when I heard tell of a medicine only to be found in this village, I thought I'd come and fetch some for us. Made the journey all by myself as well, if you can believe it.
But, well, as luck would have it, I've not enough gold for the medicine. 'Twill be a shame to return empty-handed after coming all this way. But what more can I do? What? You'd do that? You'd get the medicine for me? Suppose there's no harm in that, if you're really sure. Oh, sir, I'd be most grateful.
Seems my luck's not as rotten as I'd thought. I'll wait right here for your return, sir. And many thanks for your kindness.
We could make the fruit reborant ourselves, or simply purchase some at Rune's apothecary here in Melv.
Ah, now I understand.
It was an eventful journey, but we made it here all right.
Hello again, sir. Say, have you brought some fruit robberint for me? Oh, well, if you do pick some up, you know where to find me.
What could yon chest be hiding? I must know.
Let us hope your curiosity will be rewarded.
Ah, well met. Here for some fruit robberint, are we?
Between you and me, guys, they're mighty easy to make. Simple as combining the ingredients, if you know what they are.
Always a pleasure.
Nothing caught your eye? Oh, that's a shame. Let's hope there's aught worth... Here you are, Master. I hope you like it. I found it myself. Better informed means better prepared. Let's speak with this Sir Lennart and learn what we can. Follow me, Master, if you would. I'll bring you to the one you seek.
A guide is most well.
Well met. You're the one who saved Ulrika's life, aren't you? She told me all about it. It was a very brave thing you did. I'm in your debt. Ulrika's as good as my daughter. Here. Consider this a small token of my gratitude. Now, tell me, are you registered with a guild? Perhaps you already know this, but registering with a guild will grant you access to specialized training, which comes in very useful when pursuing a vocation. Well now, that won't do. You need only speak with the innkeeper to register. Go on, 'twill only take a moment. If there is aught you wish to know of vocations, mayhap I can advise you. 'Tis a vocation for those who seek to master the dagger. Such blades lack heft, though this grants them the advantage of speed. Thieves favor light armor, which leaves them more vulnerable to attacks than those of other vocations. Their talents depend upon their finesse and ability to compensate for the length of their blade through sheer agility. 'Tis a vocation for those who seek to master the sword and shield. Fighters favor a balanced approach, excelling in both offense and defense, and can adapt to any situation. I am a fighter myself, and should there come a time when you impress me with your prowess, I might be willing to impart unto you some of what I know. Naturally, it is a vocation for those who seek to master the bow, an exceptionally useful long-ranged weapon. At close range, however, a bow is nary more useful than a walking stick. Aye, the secret to being a successful archer is maintaining distance between you and your foes. Very well. There is no wrong choice in any case. It is entirely up to you which vocation you adopt. But I shan't take up any more of your time. Pray, be well.
Moment long awaited. I knew it was only a matter of time before your skills reached a new height.
Here at the inn, we also offer changes of vocation for those who seek it. I get so few customers, you see, that I can manage both roles myself. But enough about me. Did you need something?
Worse things than turning in early, I must say.
I trust we've all inspected our equipment.
Come, we've much to be getting on with. I hope you slept well.